Hi guys, today I'm going to do a video I've been wanting to film for ages because today I'm going to talk about some popular books that I don't like. If you have been following my videos for a little while, you know that I have some pretty unpopular opinions. And I know a lot of people like to watch these kind of videos about popular books that people don't like. And I personally really love to watch these kind of videos, so that is why I thought I would film one. So yeah, in this video I'm going to be pretty harsh on some very popular books, and I think it almost goes without saying, but these are just my opinions, and if I don't like a book that you do like, then I'm not offending you or attacking you in any way. So please don't take any of this personally and just be nice. But yeah, if you clicked on this video, you probably want to see me bash on some very popular books, so yeah, that is what I'm going to do. The first popular book that I don't like is Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. Fangirl is about a girl named Kat who writes a lot of fanfiction about a fictional series called the Simon Snow series. And this is very much like a parody of the Harry Potter series. And at the beginning of the book, Kat and her twin sister Ren go off to college, but her twin sister Ren wants to be more independent instead of always being together with her twin sister. So Kat, who is quite anxious, is being left very much alone at college, and that is where this book starts basically. But yeah, I was really, really disappointed by this book. As the title suggests, this book is supposed to be about fanfiction, about fangirling, about the fandom in general. But in my experience, it really isn't. I mean, yeah, of course Kat writes fanfiction, but that is basically it. There is no interacting with other people online in the fandom, and there's no rereading the books, and there's just a lot of things missing that I feel are supposed to be in a fandom. It just feels very self-centered around Kat, like she writes this fanfiction and that is the only thing she does that involves the fandom. And even that fanfiction isn't that important for a major part of the book. And honestly, like all the little bits of fanfiction about Simon Snow and Bass in between chapters, I really couldn't care less about them. At some point I just started to skip them because they are not relevant to the story in any way, so I really wasn't interested in those bits. So that is my first main complaint. But the second thing that really annoys me in this book are all the characters. I'm sorry, but Kat is just really, really, really stupid. I get that she has social anxiety, and it wasn't that part that annoyed me. I get that that part can be very relatable to a lot of readers. And if you can relate to Kat, then that is great for you. I personally couldn't, but I'm very happy if you could really relate to this character. But what I didn't like is that Kat could be so incredibly naive and just simply stupid sometimes. It just really, really annoyed me. Kat has a twin sister, Ren, who wants to be more independent at the start of college. And Kat just doesn't get that. She just doesn't understand that her twin sister wants to have her own life sometimes. But I also really didn't like Ren as a character because Ren just ignores her sister for a large part of the book. She's really mean to her, so I didn't like both of these sisters. Also, Kat is taking a creative writing course, a very prestigious course at that college. And of course, because Kat is such a special little snowflake, she's amazing at everything that she does with her writing. Everyone keeps saying how good she is and how amazing she is, and it just annoyed me so much. Because even if you are amazing at writing, you sometimes need a little feedback and you sometimes need a little bit of editing. And if you are such an amazing writer, why would you take a creative writing course in the first place? And then at some point Kat does something really, really stupid with a assignment for that creative writing course. And if you read the book, you probably know what I'm talking about. And then for the first time ever, she gets a little bit of critique from her teacher because she says, "You can't do this with an assignment." And then Kat gets completely upset because she gets a little bit of critique on her writing for the very first time, and she basically breaks apart, and I could just facepalm myself because it was just so annoying. And yeah, as for the other characters, the male main character Levi, is that how you pronounce it? I just didn't care for him that much. He just didn't really do it for me. I know a lot of people really love him and think he's amazing and really cute, but I personally wasn't just that interested in him. And yeah, overall, I didn't actively hate this book. I don't think it's like a terrible, terrible book. I just was very disappointed because I had expected so much more of it. It is, of course, a very easy read. You can read it very fast, and If you're really into contemporaries, you probably love it a lot more than I did. But for me, if I don't like the characters of a book, then I very much don't like the book in general, because the characters are very, very important to me. So yeah, I'm not planning on reading anything by Rainbow Rowell anytime soon, because I just don't like her writing that much. And then another contemporary that I really didn't like is To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. So I read this book last summer because I wanted to read some contemporaries during my summer holiday, and I read it without knowing that it was such a popular book. I had barely heard a thing about it. I only had heard like the title once or twice. So I read it and I thought it was awful, and then I went to Goodreads expecting like a lot of negative reviews, but there were only like 5-star and 4-star reviews, and I was kind of surprised that it was such a popular book. I really didn't know that. A lot of my complaints for To All the Boys I've Loved Before are the same as with Fangirl. So that is basically that I don't like the characters all that much. This book is about a girl named Lara Jean, and every time she loves a boy, and when she says love, she means has a crush on, she writes that boy a love letter, and she expresses all her feelings in that letter so that she can get a bit of closing. But she never sends those letters, she keeps them to herself, like a little bit of a memory or something, I don't know. But then at the beginning of the book, the letters are accidentally sent to all the boys that she's loved before, and yeah, that is the plot, but actually it really isn't all that much. So Lara Jean is supposed to be a 16-year-old, but she feels like she's 11, she's really not that mature. And I'm not saying that you have to be mature at 16 years old, but she really felt like a young child. And the same as with Kat in Fangirl, I felt that Lara Jean was kind of naive and sometimes a little bit stupid and just not very likable in general. And apart from that, it's a super cutesy YA teenage romance, and I just never really liked those books, I guess. The whole book was super predictable, it just, all those books go the same, you know how it's going to end. For me, I just really missed a lot of depth in all the characters, and like the same with Lara Jean's sisters or with her dad or with all those boys that she's loved. As I said, I read it a year ago and I've basically forgotten about half of it because it's not a memorable book. But yeah, apparently this book is very popular, so if you liked it, that's good for you, but it's really not something for me. And the next book I want to talk about is Caraval by Stephanie Garber. Caraval is about this sort of circus-like thing festival, and it's about two sisters who go there and have to solve a mystery. It came out at the beginning of this year and I was so excited to read it. I absolutely adore circus themed books, and this book promised to be like the night circus and be magical and whimsical, but then this book was such an incredible letdown and I was so disappointed. So first of all, this book is nothing like the night circus. If you like the night circus, you don't have to expect to like this book as well, because it's something completely different. I've read the entire book and I still don't know what Caraval is exactly. It's supposed to be a circus, but then you read it and it feels more like an actual town or city. And there aren't any performances, you just have to like solve a mystery to win the main prize, but It's all very vague and very unclear. And for me, it really didn't feel magical at all. I didn't get a beautiful magical feeling from this book. And again, I really didn't like the characters of this book. I don't even remember the main character's name. What was it? Scarlet? Yeah, her name is Scarlet, but she's just so forgettable that I can't even tell you what her character is like. This book is full of like tropes, especially with the romance, just full with all your typical romance tropes, like instant love and like describing the color of each other's eyes with very weird words, and it just annoyed me. And as I said, a lot of things about the story for me were very unclear, and then at the ending of the book, like, it's in complete chaos and I just didn't know what to think anymore. And again, I don't like actively hate this book, thinking that it's like terrible, completely awful, but it's just so uninteresting and it really didn't have my attention. And I believe there's a second book coming out, but I'm not going to read that because, again, I just couldn't care less about what happens with these main characters. I'll just stick with the Night Circus as my favorite circus-themed book, and Yeah, I don't really want to read this one ever again. So now we're getting to Sarah J. Maas's books, and this is probably going to be interesting. And I'm going to start with Throne of Glass, Sarah J. Maas's first series. The Throne of Glass series is incredibly popular and people adore it and they love it so much. But I have only read the first two books, Throne of Glass and Crown of Midnight, and I really wasn't that impressed. So I don't really hate this series. I don't really have a lot of strong feelings toward this series. I do have that with the A Court of Thorns and Roses series, which we're going to talk about in a minute. So we're going to talk about that later. But with the Throne of Glass series, I had read the first book and I just found it very underwhelming. So Throne of Glass is about an assassin named Selena, and she's going to take part in a tournament, and the winner of the tournament can become the king's champion, so basically the king's personal assassin. So when I heard that premise, and I really didn't know Sarah J. Maas at the time, I was really interested because I love like tournaments and fighting, and it sounded a bit like The Hunger Games. But then I read it and the first thing that I noticed was that I really didn't like this writing style. The writing of Sarah J. Maas's books are very dramatic and that just isn't something for me. But for a book that is supposed to be about a magical tournament, it was quite boring, but still I didn't hate it and I wanted to give the series another chance, so I did read Crown of Midnight, especially because a lot of people said that the second book was way better and that the first book really isn't the best of the series and that you should really like go on to appreciate the series. But unfortunately, I also really didn't like Crown of Midnight because it really felt like much of the same as the first book to me. There are supposed to be a lot of amazing plot twists in Crown of Midnight, and for me they weren't really plot twists. I could predict them like miles away. So that is when I decided to DNF this series, because it's just boring and I don't have any feelings towards it, like not negative and not positive. But there is a series that I do have very strong negative feelings towards, and that is the A Court of Thorns and Roses series, also by Sarah J. Maas. So let me start off by saying that I didn't hate A Court of Thorns and Roses, the first book. I actually quite liked this one. And this book is sort of a Beauty and the Beast retelling. It's about a girl named Feyre, and she kills a animal slash fairy or something, and then she has to live with a high lord across the wall of their world. I thought the story was fun and entertaining. I mean, it was not my favorite read of the year, but I did enjoy it. I mean, there are some YA tropes in here and it is a bit typical, but it didn't annoy me that much. I quite liked this one. So I was interested to pick up the second book, A Court of Mist and Fury. But boy, did I not like this book. And this might be my most unpopular opinion out of everything, because this book is so, so well loved. I haven't seen anything like it. Nothing but 5-star ratings, nothing but love, and it was everyone's number one on their favorite books of 2016 videos. So naturally, I was really excited to read it, but then I read it and I was completely disappointed. And there is one big reason for my disappointment, and that is Recent. I just do not see why everyone likes Recent. Recent is supposed to be perfect and an amazing feminist and like every girl's dream, but I don't think he's that perfect. And apart from that, it is really hard for me to say what I did not like about this book without spoiling the entire series, because it is the second book in a series, of course. And there were some good parts in this book. It's not the worst book in the series, because that is the last one. But there were some good parts, but there were also some really bad parts. As I said, Sarah J. Maas's writing is very dramatic, and especially in this book and in the third book, nothing is subtle. I sometimes feel that she really forces some changes really onto her readers. Like, you're supposed to like this character right now, and I'm going to make you like this character if you want it or not. But yeah, when I read this book and I did not like it very much, I felt like I was the only one in the entire world. But yeah, I just couldn't see what everyone was seeing. And I did have some really strong emotions towards this book. I mean, there were mostly negative, but I was kind of invested in the story. And that is why I eventually did decide to pick up the third book, which is A Court of Winks and Ruin. But yeah, if you have seen my review about this book, which I will put a link to down below in the description box, you know that, again, I really didn't like this book. This one is definitely the worst in the entire trilogy. It's full of problems. It's just, I don't like it. Again, recent, like, that storyline just continues and it's even getting worse. Again, the writing is way too dramatic and, again, nothing is subtle. And if you want to hear me talk about in more detail towards this book and want to hear me talk about in more detail about the entire series with spoilers, then you should really watch that review video because I go in way more depth in that video. But yeah, Sarah J. Maas, I don't like her books. And she's really not an author for me, and I'm probably making myself very unpopular with this opinion, I know. But I also know that I'm not the only one, so if you don't like these popular books, like, you're not alone, I don't like them either, so it's okay, we all have different opinions. But I'm not picking up a book by her ever again, that is for certain. And the last book I'm going to talk about today is Stalking Jack the Ripper by Carrie Maniscalco. And I don't know if this is an incredibly popular book, I mean, I haven't seen it around that much. But the things that I did see were mostly positive, and that is why I picked it up in the first place. Stalking Jack the Ripper is a historical fiction novel, and it's about a girl named Audrey Rose Wadsworth, and she's the daughter of a wealthy lord during Victorian times. But secretly, Audrey Rose is really interested in forensic science and in examining bodies, so she does that with her uncle. And then the Jack the Ripper murders start to happen, and Audrey Rose goes investigate that murders, and that's basically what the book is about. So don't get me wrong, I love historical fiction novels, and I absolutely love history. I study history. Like, history is a very important part of my life. But this book almost offended me. That is how much I hated it. This one I did, like, actively hate. I did not like this book at all. Audrey Rose is a proper lady, and she does things that aren't that suitable for a wealthy lady. Audrey Rose likes to remind us of that every 5 seconds. Basically, every page is full of phrases like, I don't need men to tell me what to do, and I know better, and I don't need anyone to take care of me because I'm awesome. When her brother asks if she's okay because she looks a little bit pale, she seriously gets mad about it because she doesn't need anyone to take care of her. She's basically a 21st century girl who is placed in Victorian times, and it annoyed me so much, especially because this feminist girl continues insulting other women from her time period all the time. Audrey Rose thinks that she is better than all the other girls because other girls only like tea parties and dresses and they are basically stupid, but Audrey Rose is smarter than that and she has better goals in life, so she is way better than all those other girls. She is constantly looking down on them and making mean comments about how they are not interesting and how tea parties are stupid and people who like them are stupid. And I'm sorry, but in my opinion, you're not a feminist if you're talking down on other women and other girls. So Audrey Rose is a modern day girl placed in Victorian times basically to fix history or something, because she's not as stupid as the other girls from the time period. She stands up for herself and she does things that aren't proper for her. And in my opinion, it is completely unbelievable that she actually grew up during that time period, because she doesn't understand anything of her own time period. And that just annoys me a little bit, because there are so many ways to write a powerful female main character who is also true to her own time period. You don't have to make her a modern day girl, I think. So even though, like, the general premise of examining the victims of Jack the Ripper and going on a investigation are very interesting, I really like that part, the character of Audrey Rose just ruined this book for me, especially because people keep telling that she's really smart, but she doesn't really do that much during the investigation. She really isn't that smart, in my opinion. As you can probably tell, I have very, very strong negative feelings towards this book. I read it at the beginning of this month, so it's still fresh in my mind, so maybe that's why. I also wrote an entire Goodreads review about it, and I will put a link to that down below so you can read that one if you want to hear more about my thoughts why I didn't like it. But I just cannot recommend this book to anyone because it made me so angry, and yeah, you can probably tell that I really didn't like this one. So this was it for my video about popular books that I don't like or simply hate in some cases. I am really curious to see what you all think of this video and if you agree with me on some of the books. This video was so fun to film because it feels really good to just throw all your feelings out there. It's really like a relief to express all your frustrations and like all your feelings towards some of these books. So if you like this video, you can go subscribe or give it a thumbs up. I post videos at least once a week, so if you want to stick around, I would really appreciate that. Please let me know down in the comments a popular book that you don't like, and then we can all talk about it and maybe have a nice little discussion. And then hopefully I will see you again in my next video. Bye!